thank you for everything, my dude.
So this is the place when I got dropped 3 weeks ago. Over here. So I'm glad I got dropped, to be honest. In the way that it happened. My cycling adventures brought me to the West African country, the Gambia. In this video, I will show my experience traveling the country and try to give a full account of incident that made me to stay 3 weeks longer than originally planned. Leaving Senegal, the border crossing to Gambia went fast and hassle-free, as I quickly managed to obtain 3 days transit visa. Unfortunately for me, many off-road tracks in Gambia were rather sandy.
I was curious why they hang around close to me, these cows. They also just want some water. Yeah, the water is not the best. I'll try to filter it.
While aiming at discovering the country of the beaten path, I continue towards administrative capital Banjul. The Gambia River indirectly defines border of the country, which is effectively a 10-kilometer wide strip of land on each side of the riverbank. The river also contains many animals like hippos and crocodiles. Though being close to the river delta, I was not able to spot them. Located in close proximity is also UNESCO heritage site, the James Island, also known as Kunta Kinte Island, used in the transatlantic slave trade and made famous by novel Roots.
Quite nice.
On the roadside, I saw honey sold in the Coke bottles. Intrigued about local products, I was excited. Although tasty, it had some smoky oak flavor. Later, I discovered it's a wild honey. I was explained that collecting wild honey is rather adventurous. Wild beehives are smoked before collecting, and later, honey is extracted by heating the honeycombs in the pot over fire, resulting in smoky flavor.
Yeah, this has been here for a while. It seems like it was a campsite at some time. Yeah, it's quite abundant right now, but looks nice. I come from Slovakia.
Huh?
Slovakia? Europe?
Europe.
Born Jew.
It is tricky to explain from which country I come. Only with the cycling fans, I don't have this problem. Thanks to a 3 times world champion, Peter Sagan.
From?
I don't know.
I don't know. Okay.
capital of Gambia, Banjul, look welcoming. Here I could really recognize why they call the country the smiling coast of Africa. My impression was even better by official language being English, meaning I finally could understand what the children shouted at me for last 3 months and even ask what am I actually eating for dinner. I arrived in Banjul in the evening, which is already a bad time to arrive in the big city. Having some street food, I was heading out of the town towards much bigger Serekunda. After a day of cycling and pushing through the rough terrain, I felt tired. Then I spotted the cemetery next to the beach, which was abandoned, with only some parting being held in the distance. Suddenly, a man on bicycle stopped and started to talk to me. After a usual introduction of my travels, he asked where I'm sleeping, which I proudly said I usually camped, and pointed on my yellow bag, while the man replied that the area is very safe, which only straightened my belief sleeping there. Cutting the talk short, I parted heading towards the cemetery. I sat down behind a sand dune while observing if the place is generally fit for camping. As I raised the tent, I saw two men passing in the distance. They moved on, but at a sudden they spotted me and started to move my direction. Raising my alarm, I grabbed my pocket knife and opened it. One of the men used a phone torch, which I followed, shining the light on them, making the taller man visibly irritated, while the shorter man, in muscular figure, remained quiet. The taller man raised the voice, saying that they are security and demanding the answers, what am I doing there? Upon hearing that they are security, I subtly placed a knife back to my pocket. Still with the raised voice, one asked for ID. By this time, I already missed my phone with the torch, which was already taken from me, unfortunately. I still didn't realize that it's a robbery. To this point, my attitude was more towards cooperating with the angry police or security rather than dealing with the robbers. The reason is that for last few months I dealt with lot of border police and customs, which tend to ask similar questions. The last point of interest for the robbers were my pockets, where I had a wallet and a pocket knife. Both were taken from me, while the men keep repeating that I'm a bad person, feeling the weight of 100,000 sefa, around 150 euro. The taller man started to retreat. At that point, I saw a wooden club in the hand of the muscular man. Suddenly, it became clear that these men come for my items. I started to be defensive, yelling for help and police. Men started to run away. At this time, I focus on the muscular man with the club in the hand, trying to prevent me from chasing them. At one point, for a few moments, I faced him while he waved the club violently in front of my face, with one of the blows landing on the left side of my body. Although my mind was clear, I did not know what to do, and my attitude was to chase them away, hoping to get some help, well, from anyone. I closely chased the man with the rampage while they were running away at their best. But when they entered the dark cemetery, I got concerned about being ambushed and with the possible safety hazard involved. My attention shifted to my property still lying on the beach, while the fear of the man returning in the bigger numbers. I quickly packed the tent, pushed the bike vigorously through the sand towards the main road. Once on the road, I consider what's next. Police station. Yes, let's go to the police station. No, it is too far. Let's ask for some help. I tried to wait on the cars, but no one stopped. The most disappointing moment was when I saw a glimpse of hope in passing by pickup truck full of armed police forces sitting in the back, passing right next to me. I yelled at them and waved, seeing a possible solution. Two out of six men waved back on me, but the car continued without hesitation for stopping, crushing all my hopes. Eventually, I arrived at the police station. After a very dangerous and educational event which happened last night, I was sheltered by a police officer living in the Banjul police barracks. I calculated the loss, 150 euro in sefa and about the same for the phone. All in all, not too bad. However, the main loss was the content of the phone, photos, banking and identification apps. The tide turned, and from the dark night, I was suddenly in the presence of lovely people, which also helped me to get hold of another good second-hand phone. Besides formalities and video editing, I spent time learning to cook Gambian dishes and exploring colorful markets. It was also impressive to see how much work women bear on their shoulders in West Africa.
This one and this one is not the same.
It felt great to find friends after months of traveling. Being genuinely welcome in someone's house, it's amazing. Which was also the main reason I stayed in Gambia. Looking back at the account of the robbery, it was my negligence which placed me in the situation. After months of traveling, I slowly let down my guard. Now I know that cities often contain criminals, and even one or more areas which are unsafe to approach even in daylight. It is important not to place oneself in a vulnerable situation, like being in a location away from people, where one cannot be heard. When thinking what should I do different, once already approached by the criminals, as they personified security, I should have asked for ID. The best way to avoid direct confrontation is scare them away. As I did not have any items for self-defense, screaming is very effective, which can alarm local people. Raging mob in Africa is often deadly, and the criminals know that. All in all, I was lucky that the situation was not that serious. After 3 weeks in Gambia, I was very sad to leave my friends, which grew close to me.
Senegal again.